You're watching it.
Victory. The subtle differences.
All the way. I'm in
TV.
Flavor.
Yeah.
Good luck.
We got all kinds of stuff. We got Turkey Turvey and his trick horses or something like that. All kinds of good stuff. We're going to have more fun than you shake a stick at tonight. Hey, but remember, the horse show continues on through May the 8th. We got 2 more weeks of horses and cowboys and cowgirls and all kinds of good stuff. Hey, next week we got dressage. Next Saturday night we got musical freestyle. I'm going to be sitting right up there with those two folks.
Here we are at the 66th Annual Del Mar National Horse Show in Del Mar, California. The most beautiful place in the world where there's horses and cowboys and cowgirls. You can't beat it. You should be here. And I am Tim Tunnell, the CEO, General Manager of the Del Mar Fairgrounds.
So you ready to have a good time? You ready to have some fun? All right, let's get the show on the road.
Hola, Del Mar.
Welcome to Del Mar and the Night of the Horse.
story and what it means to be a Del Mar today?
I was kind of surprised. This is something special. And I wasn't expecting it, not at all. It's like a totally surprise. It was my hobby in Canada. You know, when I moved over here 20 years ago, I turned the hobby as a job, which was a pleasure to do it because it was the thing I like to do. So I've been full-time, you know, trainers. By now, you know, after training mine in Canada as a hobby, then here I did it, you know, full-time for 21 years. One way or the other, I came every year, like as a judge or like a spectator or participating, and I think I won a Perpetual Trophy twice before with two of my horses. So, I'm a good fan for Del Mar. Yeah, that this is something special.
I've been coming to the Del Mar Nationals since 1962. And as long as I can remember, Ralph Walker was a ring steward, was a part of the Del Mar Fairgrounds. And that award is a perpetual award. It's based off sportsmanship, because he was a true sportsman. Today the recipient, a dear friend of mine and my wife, Sponsy, was Yvonne Mathieu. He rides reining horses as a non-pro and went professional as well. He's just a great man, great sport, and we're very fortunate to have him here to give that to him.
How many reigning Olympiads have you sent to the Olympics?
I think approximately 11 that have shown at our shows, whether it's Del Mar, Hollywood Charity Show, or other reignings that we've done in the past.
That is amazing. And is that just something that is just really coming on strong right now on the international scene as well?
Especially being part of the Olympics, being the first Western discipline to be a part is a huge draw.
And you're right on the forefront of that, ushering that into the global stage of the world as we get into equestrian sports. London 2012, do you got any favorites coming up?
They're all my favorites. I think being a part of it for so long and understanding the tradition of it, which is the importance of Del Mar, I think that's been very helpful for me. But yes, it's always a challenge. And we always expect the challenge when we come here. But we always accomplish what we set out to do. And that's to keep the exhibitors happy, give them a great venue to show their horses.
Larry Gimple for the Del Mar National. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you for being here.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well done.
Hey, Jerk.
Uh-huh.
I can't get this thing up. You gotta push it from the side. You got stronger hands.
Get the microphone.
This thing is calm there, man.
First day of running, Ada.
I hope you will enjoy this evening and never forget that next week is
just
the $100,000 Grand Prix. So please welcome in some of our top runners with
she's a bit used to that tonight. Now we go into the canter. And the pirouette. Ladies and gentlemen, this is... once. This is definitely upper class dressage, just as we should always have it. That's a zigzag. I think a little bit running there.
Event. We're having a great time. We got a great crowd here. The weather is beautiful as always here in beautiful Del Mar. And you should be here because we are, and we're having a great time.
ladies and gentlemen, the top horse rider combination in this country. Stephen Peters from the United States with Akiko Yamazaki's Rebel.
Obviously very alert and looking at his surroundings, but I was very pleased because he held it together. When he looked, you can definitely tell, but he did his job and didn't make big mistakes, so it was
nice. Very good. And yeah. You? How's it feel to be back in the saddle?
Great.
Exactly that what I was expecting, and he looked absolutely fantastic. I watched Jenny a little bit in the warm-up while I was warming up, and I had to tell myself I got to focus on my own horse because Jenny's horse was looking so good, and I can't even say how proud I am tonight that this really happened, because it's a very difficult horse that Jenny rode to.